When you talk about the BOD, so BOD can be defined, there is no particular definition, but this is used to estimate the amount of organic material in water. So based on the DO, we can estimate the amount of organic matter to be in water. So here generally DO, that is dissolved oxygen. So it is the amount of oxygen required present in the water for required for the aquatic living organisms to sustain. So here when you take that on a graph, draw a graph on x-axis and y-axis, where you take the concentration on y-axis and flow of discharge. So here sewage, more organic material. Here the DO, this is shown with the green color. The DO decreases when the sewage is more organic material is present, and it increases when the water is less sewage. Flow of sewage is less organic material, it increases, and the sewage organic material is more, it will decrease. And when the DO is high, the biological oxygen demand will be less, but based on the more sewage, the biological oxygen demand will increase, and if it is the less organic material, the biological oxygen demand will be low. So it is vice versa. This is DO, this is BOD. So when the BOD is when dissolved oxygen is higher, greater, BOD requirement is less. And this is in the, when DO is greater, BOD is less, and this is in the less polluted water. And when BOD is greater, DO will be less. This is in the high polluted organic material containing water. So here organic. So apart from this, what does it happen in the case of the organic material? So here when the organic material will be more, and when the organic material is rich in nutrients like phosphorus and nitrogen, nutrient when the new organic material is rich in nutrients like phosphorus and nitrogen. Water bodies will get a blue color because of planktonic growth. So this is called as algal bloom. Very important one more question. 2018 and 2019 PU one more question. So this planktonic growth, if it is this algal bloom, this gives a distinct color and smell to the water. This is because of high amount of nutrients like phosphorus and nitrogen contained more in the water, including the organic material. So here the planktonic growth will lead to the fish and other local aquatic organisms death. So here BOD increase as well as the planktonic growth, because of rich nutrients, also sometimes may damage the quality of the food, the living standards of the fishes, and leads to the mortality of the fishes. So here, when you talk about this water pollution, you might have learned about in the 15th chapter, Eichhornia crab. This is, that is water hyacinth plant you all have heard. The name of this is also called as Terror of Bengal. The plant is also called as Terror of Bengal. It was brought from United Kingdom to Bengal because of excellent shape of leaves and mauve colored flowers. Mauve colored flowers that was brought, and it is having high regeneration capacity. And it grows more is almost spread most of the water bodies of Bengal. Because of which, what happens? Generally, in standing water, it grows. Blocks water movement . So why this is called Tenor of Bengal? Iconia crepis is generally called as water hyacinth. It is called Tenor of Bengal. It has almost blocked all the water bodies of Bengal. It was brought from the UK by the then Britishers to India and some of the visitors to India. Because of its excellent shape of the leaf and bright color, and it is a mauve colored flowers, means it is between the pink and red. So it was brought to India and it has got high regeneration capacity, so it is called as, it is also called as alien species. Already you might have come across alien species. Okay, HO habitation, HOAC, co-extinction, habitat loss, something similar like I learned in the 15th chapter. So it is one of the alien species which has dominated Indian water bodies. It will mostly grow in the standing water, blocks water movement, and also decreases water dissolved oxygen and increase BOD. So the requirement of oxygen will be decreases water dissolved oxygen, and it is a threat to aquatic organisms, aquatic living organisms generally die because of more growth of this. Why? And it is also a positive pollution indicator. This is neat question. Is a positive pollution indicator. Is a positive pollution indicator. So, because of water pollution, apart from the above discussed points, so we can also see that there is a chance of the sewage from domestic or hospitals can have pathogens. Pathogen means disease causing microorganisms. Disease causing microorganisms. And there is a possibility of causing the cholera, typhoid, jaundice, amebiasis, cholera, typhoid, jaundice, amebiasis, and dysentery means amebiasis only. So here the cholera is caused by Vibrio cholerae. Typhoid is caused by Salmonella typhi. Jaundice is because of hepatitis B virus or many other reasons, many bacteria also. Amebiasis is caused by Entamoeba histolytica. So here there is a chance of neat questions from these positivity neat point of view, very important related to the neat point of view. Apart from this, so the other sources, industrial effluents like paper industry, petrol industry, metal manufacturing and metal processing industry, and chemical processing and chemical manufacturing industry, processing and manufacturing industries, there is a chance of contamination of water. Contamination means pathogens. Contamination, pollution. Actually, we should use pollution of water. So, in this, there is a chance of LCF. L, lead, C, cadmium, C, copper, mercury. So this is also very important, and when there is a less than greater than 5 milligrams per centimeter cube, 5 milligrams per centimeter, 5 grams per centimeter cube, that water is unfit and highly polluted water with industrial waste, industries. 5 grams per centimeter cube. So these are heavy metals. So generally, some toxic substances, undergo biomagnification. Bio means living organisms. Magnification means increasing concentration of chemicals. So here in the living organisms, increasing the concentration of certain chemicals in the body is called as biomagnification. That is, it is the successive accumulation of toxic chemicals successive accumulation of toxic chemicals in the living organisms at successive tropical levels is called biomagnification. So in the case of this biomagnification, we can see that DDT, dichloro diethyl tetracycline, which is a pesticide. So here, when you see the water, it has entered, it is generally a pesticide, it has entered the water from the other places, like agricultural plants, crops. When it has entered the water, water is a bigger water body and it is fat soluble only, not water mixable. So it was only 0.003 ppb, that is, here ppb means parts per million, 0.1 million means 10 lakhs. So it is 0.003 per billion. That is million into 100. Yeah. Here billion means million into 100. Million means 10 lakhs. Units and subjects, thousands, 10,000 lakhs, 10 lakhs. So it is 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs. So it is considerably moving into the plants. From the plants to small fishes, from fishes to, from the fishes to bigger fishes, fishes to crane or hawk or birds. Till it has reached the birds, it was 25 parts per million, means 0.003 parts per billion. It has increased to 25 through the successive tropical level. As a result, the pelican population in America decreased and America 1972 America as banned DDT. America has banned DDT because it is affecting calcium metabolism in birds. That is the reason to decrease of population in pelicans. And it is also showing serious mutagenic effects on other living organisms, including humans. Other mutagenic, including human beings.